Welcome to the Graduate Research Forum for the spring of 2024. My name is Leah Enriquez, and I am a graduate student in the Department of Organization, Workforce, and Leadership Studies at Texas State University. The title of my research study is Social Media, News Consumption, and Recent College Graduates of Color. What if I told you that in this era of digital connectivity, the convergence of social media news consumption and recent college graduates of color presents a compelling area for exploration? Picture this. The Pew Research Center shared that in 2021, news organizations vigorously disseminated content across various social media platforms, with a staggering 96% of those outlets actively engaging on platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. Now consider this. Young adults of color who rely on social media for political information find their perspectives and political engagement profoundly influenced, with significant implications for society at large. This was confirmed by research from Wang et al. Adding to the complexity, Rowan Kenyon shared that discrimination and racial hatred have manifested on university campuses and online, underscoring the digital challenges faced by these communities. That's where my research comes in. The purpose of this study was to examine the experiences of recent college graduates of color who use social media to consume news. Three research questions guided the study. How do recent college graduates of color use social media to consume news? Why do recent college graduates of color use social media to consume news? And how does the use of social media to consume news impact recent college graduates of color? The participants comprised five individuals actively immersed in social media for news consumption. All of them were first-time college graduates within the past 5 years, and each participant fell within the age range 25 to 30 years old. They all also self-identified as belonging to a low socioeconomic background. Let's break it down. The design was qualitative. Data collection employed a semi-structured interview protocol complemented by the use of field notes, while data analysis centered in thematic coding of major themes and findings, which resulted in three major findings: news consumption patterns, identity institutional perspectives and social dynamics, and lastly, instant news impact. The first major theme, news consumption patterns, reveals participants' unanimous preference for accessing social media content through their phones, highlighting the convenience of instant connectivity. Brianna expressed this sentiment: "It's very simple being instantly connected. We always carry our phones with us." The participants' agreement underscores the prevailing sentiment that smartphones offer unparalleled accessibility and immediacy, reshaping the contemporary landscape of social media engagement, cemented by previous research from Guo and Chen. Additionally, TikTok emerged as the dominant choice for instant news access, as noted by Gina. "My favorite platform is probably TikTok. It's just kind of addicting." However, three participants favored Instagram as an alternative, and interestingly, the sole male participant, Chance, preferred Reddit, a preference contrasted by skepticism from female participants like Diane. "I try to stay away from it altogether. There is lots of misinformation getting spread there." These diverse platform preferences shed light on how individuals navigate and perceive social media spaces, even from a gendered lens. Diane also emphasized the presence of traditional news media on these platforms, stating, "Lots of traditional news media are on TikTok," illustrating how users blend information from common influencers to establish sources like the New York Times TikTok page. For the second major findings in identity, institutional perspectives, and social dynamics, the prevailing sentiments were palpable, with all female participants expressing a sense of detachment. Alex, for instance, conveyed feeling marginalized as a woman of color on a college campus. She said, "We just feel like a number in a sense." This sense of marginalization contributed to a disconnection from established systems augmented by traditional news outlets. Another theme that arose was a deep-seated distrust of institutions, notably universities and the government. Chance revealed some postgraduate discoveries of corruption within his university, which contributed to his pervasive feeling of distrust. Diana also highlighted governmental neglect, expressing, "The government is quite neglectful of, you know, helping people in times of crisis." There's also a sense of shared experiences as the participants turned to social media as a tool to find community. This was particularly highlighted in previous research by Lee and when Gina responded to a racist incident shared on social media by a Black female Harvard University student. Gina expressed, "It's happening everywhere. Racism is not just here. I am not just in a bubble, and it is only happening in my bubble, you know? It does happen everywhere, and I think that's the kind of thing that's been helpful to make me feel like I'm not alone." This shared acknowledgement of common experiences through social media platforms served as a powerful source of connection, assuaging feelings of isolation and reinforcing a sense of solidarity among the participants. In part three of the major findings of Instant News Impact, Gina's reflections on feeling overwhelmed and desensitized shed light on the individual impact of constant exposure to significant media events such as school shootings or police brutality, which has led to a diminished sense of urgency because it's always there. This influence also extends to the relational level, as Diane shared. She's had challenges in expressing her identity within her social circle. "I can't firmly express who I am." Except for Alex, all participants acknowledged social media had an impact on their perspectives, with Brianna admitting that she sometimes made judgments based on online behavior or political affiliation, stating, "I think they're either incels or bigots." These findings reveal a continuum of multifaceted and far-reaching consequences of social media. There was also a heavy sense of fear that surfaced regarding the potential weaponization of instant news access against the wider society, conceded by research from Marshall. This was articulated by Chance, who highlighted, "It allows people, companies, or groups with an agenda to capitalize on collective outrage, because negative news spreads quickly." Finally, Gina also expressed how the hunger for immediate information makes it too easy to mask fake news as news. Diana echoed these sentiments, expressing concern about the credibility of information on social media. "Some of the information that users are getting from influencers, getting their sources from, is considered credible, but then they turn that into sound-bitten information to further drive whatever their agenda is." This study offers implications for theory, practice, policy, and future research. To expand, limitations included number of participants, lack of gender diversity, and limited geographic representation. For theory, it added to existing literature. For practice, the study offers implications for college students of color who use social media to consume news, their instructors, their families and friends, and social media platforms used for consumption of news. Additionally, policy offers implications for higher education institutions as they should prioritize diversity initiatives, while federal policy should promote accurate information and transparency on social media platforms. As for future research, future studies should address limitations and continue exploring diverse samples, integrating qualitative and quantitative methods to understand evolving news consumption patterns and impact. In conclusion, this research has illuminated the experiences of recent college graduates of color who use social media for news consumption. By analyzing device and platform preferences, impact on interpersonal assumptions and relationships, as well as concerns, several major findings have emerged. Firstly, the study revealed a preference for smartphone access and a variety of platform preferences, highlighting the diverse ways individuals engage with news content. Secondly, the use of social media for news consumption can evoke a range of negative emotions due to the exposure to biased or inaccurate information, discrimination, and the overwhelming nature of social media feeds. Additionally, exposure to diverse perspectives can lead to both positive and negative outcomes, facilitating meaningful discussion but also reinforcing biases and polarization. As we move forward, it's imperative to continue exploring these dynamics and their implications. By fostering critical engagement, promoting media literacy, and advocating for diverse representation, we can navigate the complexities of social media news consumption more effectively. Together, we can work towards a media landscape that fosters understanding, empathy, and positive societal change. If you found this video to be informative, I invite you to join the conversation, share your insights, and advocate for informed and inclusive news consumption practices in the comments below, or hit that like button. Thanks for your time.